When we divide one number by another, we are really asking the question, how many copies of the second number are in the first? For example, when we ask what is 6 divided by 2, we are really asking how many copies of 2 are in 6. To model this quotient, we'll use Cuisenaire rods from the Cuisenaire environment created by Enrich. If we let this dark green rod equal 6 units and the red rod equal 2 units, we can see it takes exactly 3 red rods to form the same length as one dark green rod, which shows us there are 3 copies of 2 in 6. And therefore, 6 divided by 2 equals 3. Now for the next part, we're asked to make a train by putting an orange rod and a brown rod together into N. Set the length of this train to 1 unit, therefore 1 whole equals 1 orange plus 1 brown. So 1 orange and 1 brown form 1 whole or 1 unit. Now that we've defined our unit, we're asked to fill in the remaining values in the table. So looking at the table, we have orange plus brown equals 1. We're also given blue equals 1 half. Let's show why this equals 1 half, and then we'll complete the table. Notice how it takes exactly 2 blue rods to form the length of 1 unit or 1 whole, which means 1 blue rod equals 1 half. Now let's determine the value of 1 dark green rod and 1 light green rod. So we'll determine how many dark green rods it takes to make 1 whole. It takes 1, 2, 3. Because it takes 3 dark green rods to form 1 whole unit, we know 1 dark green rod equals 1/3. Now we'll determine the value of 1 light green rod. We begin by determining how many light green rods it takes to make 1 whole unit. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Because it takes 6 light green rods to form 1 whole unit, 1 light green rod equals 1/6. And now determine the value of a red rod as well as a white rod. We begin by determining how many red rods it takes to make 1 whole unit. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Because it takes 9 red rods to form 1 whole unit, we know 1 red rod equals 1/9. Now for the white rod, it'll take too long to line all of these up, but notice how it takes 2 white rods to form the length of 1 red rod. So if it takes 9 red rods to form 1 whole unit, it will take 18 white rods to form 1 whole unit, and therefore 1 white rod equals 1/18. Let's go to the next part. For part C, we're asked to use this technique and the table of values to answer the following questions. And we're given an example. The first question is, what is 1 divided by 1 half? In other words, how many copies of 1 half are in 1? And we should recognize there are 2 copies of 1 half in 1, and therefore 1 divided by 1 half is equal to 2. If we go back to the rods, this is the unit. Notice how it takes 2 blue rods to form 1 whole unit. Each blue rod equals 1 half. This shows there are 2 copies of 1 half in 1. Now we'll look at 3 more questions. What is 2/3 divided by 1/9? In other words, how many copies of 1/9 are in 2/3? Let's answer this question using our rods. Remember, 1/9 is equal to 1 red rod, and 2/3 is equal to 2 copies of 1/3, which means 2/3 is equal to 2 dark green rods. So we could also word this question as, how many copies of a red rod are in 2 dark green rods? Let's go back to our rods and figure this out. So we begin with 2 dark green rods, which is equal to 2/3. We want to determine how many 1/9 are in 2/3. So we need to determine how many red rods are in 2 dark green rods. Well, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So because there are 6 red rods and 2 dark green rods, we know there are 6 1/9ths in 2/3. Next, what is 1 1/3 divided by 1/9th? In other words, how many copies of 1/9th are in 1 1/3? Using the rods, we can ask the question, how many copies of a red rod, where a red rod is equal to 1/9th, are in 4 dark green rods? The reason this is 4 dark green rods is because, remember, 1 dark green rod is equal to 1/3, so 3 dark green rods would be 3/3 or 1, and therefore 4 dark green rods would be 1 1/3. Let's go back to our rods and figure this out. So let's line up 4 dark green rods. We already know it took 6 red rods to form the length of 2 dark green rods, and therefore it should take 12 red rods to form the length of 4 dark green rods. Let's go ahead and complete this train. Notice how it does take 12 rods to form the length of 4 dark green rods, which tells us there are 12 1/9ths in 1 1/3. And now for the last question, we're asked, what is 1 2/3 divided by 1 1/2? In other words, how many copies of 1 1/2 are in 1 2/3? Because 1 blue rod is equal to 1/2, 1 1/2 would be 3 blue rods, and because 1 dark green rod is 1/3, 1 2/3 would be 5 dark green rods. So using rods, we need to determine how many copies of 3 dark blue rods are in 5 dark green rods. So we begin with 5 dark green rods, which equals 1 2/3. And now to determine how many copies of 1 1/2 are in 1 2/3, we determine how many copies of 3 blue rods are in this amount. So 3 blue rods is equal to 1 copy of 1 1/2. So there's 1 copy of 1 1/2. Notice how there's more than 1 copy of 1 1/2 in 1 2/3, or there's more than 3 blue rods in 5 dark green rods. Looks like this amount is equal to the length of 1 light green rod. We need to figure out how much of a copy this amount is compared to 3 blue rods. So we'll determine how many light green rods it takes to make 3 blue rods. So it takes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Because it takes 9 light green rods to form the length of 3 blue rods, 1 green rod is 1/9th of a copy of 3 blue rods, which means there are 1 1/9 copies of 3 blue rods in 5 dark green rods, or there are 1 1/9 copies of 1 1/2 in 1 2/3. So this example is a lot more challenging than the previous examples. So I hope you'll take some time and analyze this model to make sure you understand exactly what's happening here. So the answer is 1 1/9. There are 1 1/9 copies of 1 1/2 in 1 2/3. I hope you found this helpful.